Hi guys, in this section we're going to use the Git command line. So what I'm going to do in this lesson is just show you where you can go to find instructions to install Git on your computer, and then we're actually going to look at some basic commands so that those of you who are completely new to using Git will have a basic understanding of the commands we're going to use throughout the section. If you head over to Google and search for install Git, you'll find various options. Now I've chosen this Atlassian page. It comes up as one of the first results. Now in here you can see that there are instructions for installing Git on Mac OS X, on Windows, and on Linux. So it's fairly straightforward as long as you just go to the operating system of your choice and then follow the instructions that are there. Now as it's different on different operating systems, I'm not going to show you how to do it, but you should be able to follow these instructions. Now I've put together a file with some of the really basic commands that you need to know when you're working with Git, and we're going to go through these in this lesson. So go to your course download, in the code directory you'll find AWS Developer Tools, and then this file which is basic Git commands. So I'm on a command prompt, I've already installed Git on my machine, and I'm just in my documents folder. And what I want to do is just to make sure that I am running Git and that it's up to date, I can run git dash dash version. And that shows me the version number. So that all looks good. I'll show you now how you can make and then initialize a repository on your computer. So I'm going to create one called my repo. So I'm just making a directory on my computer. I'm then going to change to that directory. So I'm in my repo. And then what I can do is run git init. And that will initialize a repository based on this folder that I've created. So now you can see that we're in the master branch. So you can see that we're in a initialized Git repository and we're in the master branch. Now what I'm going to do is create a file. So I'm just going to create a file called my test file. Now I'm on Mac, so I'm using the touch utility to do that. That just creates an empty file. So if I ran the ls command, I can see that file. If you're on Windows, then it might be different. I'm not sure what the best command is for you to use, but there'll be an equivalent. Or just go to the directory and create yourself a test file. Now that we have a file, let's run a command which is git status. Now what happens here is it actually lets me know that there's an untracked file. So just down here we can see it says untracked files, my test file. And that's because I've added a file to the file system, but I haven't added it in Git. So I need to do that. Now I'm going to clear the screen just to bring things down to the middle for you. And now I'm going to run git add, and I can either give it the file name explicitly just to add that one file, or if I had more than one file, I can run git add dash a, and that will add that file. So now if I run git status again, you can see things are different. So it now recognizes that a file's been added. It's changed it from being read and untracked to being a new file that's recognized by Git. But it hasn't been committed yet. It says changes to be committed. So to commit it, we can run git commit dash m, and then we give it a message. So typically it's a best practice to put in some descriptive message here that lets you know what you've actually committed. I'm just going to call this first commit and hit enter. And that's done. So now we've actually committed that file. If I clear the screen again and rerun git status, we can see there's nothing to commit and the working tree is clean. So those were a few very, very simple commands, and we're going to be using those commands in this section. The only other command that we'll use is the git clone command. That's where we clone an existing repository. So what we did here is we created our own directory and we initialized it as a git repository. The other thing you can do is take the repository URL of a repository that's either in GitHub, or what we'll be doing in the course is finding a repository in AWS CodeCommit, and then we can clone that repository down to our computer, and then we can work on the code locally. Now just to show you how that works, I've gone to GitHub and I'm looking at this AWS samples page. If I just choose one of these popular repositories and then click on the code here, so I get the drop down menu, and we can see this URL. So I can copy this URL, and back on my computer, I'm going to change directories back up to my documents, and then I'm going to run git clone and put in the URL. So that is now cloning the repository from GitHub down to my local computer. Now I won't be able to make any changes commit those changes and then push them back up to the repository because it's not my repository. But when we're working with CodeCommit, we will do exactly that. So we'll actually clone a repository from CodeCommit down to our computers, change the code, commit that code, and then push it back up to CodeCommit. So as you can see, that's completed. If I change directories into this AWS serverless repository, now I have the master branch of the AWS serverless workshops. Now, we're not going to use this. I'm just going to delete the two repositories that I have on my computer. But this was just to show you an example of working with Git. And in the next hands-on lesson, we'll be going into CodeCommit and creating a repository in AWS CodeCommit.